Many bumper covers have built-in stress areas that typically break in the same area and often break without much force. Repairing it incorrectly could result in the bumper breaking again, just reinstalling the bumper. This Honda bumper cover is a good example. Any bending of the bumper is concentrated in this small area. Align the brake and apply aluminum body tape to keep it in alignment while you do the repair. Aluminum body tape is very stiff and can withstand the heat from the welding process. On this repair, we doubled up on the aluminum tape to better keep it in alignment. On the back side, expose new plastic with the die grinder and a roll-off disc. Next, V-groove along the crack line with a tapered burr. Aim the flow of air at the intersection of the rod and the plastic that you are welding. Be sure to melt both the rod and the existing plastic. On this particular weld, we are doing two passes with the rod. While the plastic is still hot, use the airless plastic welder to smooth the weld. To better distribute the bending forces on this bumper cover, lay down several passes of the polypropylene strip on the backside for reinforcement. Again, while the plastic is still hot, use the airless plastic welder to smooth the weld. Allow the weld to cool completely before starting on the front side. Remove the aluminum body tape and use a tapered burr to grind a V-groove along the crack line. Grind deep enough that you can see the weld of the backside. Aim the flow of air at the intersection of the rod and the plastic that you are welding. Be sure to melt both the rod and the existing plastic. On this particular weld, we are doing two passes with the rod. While the plastic is still hot, use the airless plastic welder to smooth the weld. Once the weld has cooled, you can sand the weld smooth. As you can see, the bending forces are no longer concentrated to the crack line, but are spread over a large area.